Okay, so let's do the proof by induction. And here's sort of an outline of how the proof should go. I always like to say proof and then give a hint as to what proof technique we're going to be using. So we're going to do a proof by induction here. Now the base case is the case where n is equal to 1, where a only has one column. And then you want to do an inductive step where you say, assume it holds for k, for n equals k, and then you want to show that it holds for n equals k plus 1. Okay, so let's start with the base case. Now, if a only has one column, then it looks something like this, alpha 1, 1 over a 2, 1. Okay, so this is now m by 1. Now, it could be that a 2, 1 is a vector of length 0. That's actually okay. Notice that this only has one principal leading submatrix. Okay, that's the matrix that's just alpha 1, 1. So what we're saying is that that matrix is non-singular. But if that matrix is non-singular, then that means that alpha 1, 1 is not 0. So we can now write down what its LU factorization is. It is, for L, it is the matrix 1. Remember, it has to have 1s on the diagonal. And A 2, 1 divided by alpha 1, 1 below it. And then right here, U is just the element alpha 1, 1. And what I've just done is I've written down what its LU factorization is, and that's really the only possible way of writing down the LU factorization, given that this element must be 1, so it's unique. All right? Now, obviously, I'm not writing down all of the little details that I'm saying here. And for that, you need to go and look at the proof that's in the notes. All right, so now we have the base case covered. And now we need to move on. Oh, before we move on, where have we seen this before? We've seen that before when we computed the multipliers, right? We saw that as part of a step in the LU factorization algorithm from the last unit. Interesting. Anyway, let's move on. Now, assume that the result holds for n equal to k. Let's show that it holds for n equals k plus 1. All right. Now, here, what we said is we'd like to expose what the structure of the matrix is and then work with it. And I'm going to do that here as well. So, we have n equals k plus 1 columns. And the way I'm going to write my matrix A is A00, A01, A10 transpose alpha 1, 1, A20, A21. Okay, so this constitutes the first k columns of the matrix, and this now is the last column. Okay? All right. Now, this has to be equal to L00 L10 transpose L20, a column of zeros, a 1 in the middle here because it's a unit upper triangle, lower triangular matrix, and then L21 below it, times the matrix U00, U01, 0, epsilon 1, 1. Okay? What I'm saying here is, if L and U exist, then they must have these different pieces in it. Now, if I can come up with what those different pieces must be, in other words, if I can give an algorithm for computing those and I can show that those are unique and that they exist, then I will have shown that any matrix with k plus 1 columns has an LU factorization. All right? But what do I know? Well, if you think about it, this part of the matrix must be equal to this part of L times that U00, because this right here ends up being multiplied by 0. So what does that mean? That means that this times this is the LU factorization of the first k columns of matrix A. And by the inductive hypothesis, we know that that exists. So by the inductive hypothesis, we know that this exists, this exists, this exists, and that exists. And if we can now use the fact that A has linearly independent columns and the fact that we know that these are unique, if we can now come up with unique steps to compute the other parts, then we're done. All right, now, this right here, A01 must be equal to this times that plus this times that. So it must be equal to L00 times U01. Okay? Alpha 11 must be equal to this times this plus this times that. So alpha 11 is equal to L10 transpose times U01 plus epsilon 11. And finally, A21 must be equal to this times that plus this times that. So we get that A21 is equal to L20 times U01 plus L21 times U11. All right? Now, let's look at the first one. We know what this is, oops, and we know what this L is, and we know that L00 has ones on the diagonal and therefore must be non-singular. What does that mean? That means that U01 can be uniquely determined from A01 at L00 by solving L00 times U01 is equal to A01. So we've determined that it's unique, and we've given ourselves a way of computing it by saying it's a matter of solving a lower triangular system. We're good. Okay, so now we know that this here is unique, right there, and we know how to compute it. Once we have that, we move on, and we know what this is, we know what that is, because that's right here, and we know what U01 is. So what that means is that we can compute alpha 11 minus L10 transpose times U01 to compute epsilon 11. And that is just, you know, that must be, the different pieces have been uniquely determined, therefore U11 has to be unique. So then the only question becomes, can U11 be zero? Because that would be a problem. But U11 can't be zero, because if it is, then this block times that block is equal to this block. But if you do this times that and this is zero, then you actually create a singular matrix. And this here is a leading principal submatrix, a principal leading submatrix of A, and it can't be singular. So what we conclude is that U11 is uniquely determined and it's not zero. And we have a formula for computing it. We're good. Then we move on. By this point, we know what L210 is because it's sitting over here. We know what A21 is because it's part of matrix A. We know what U01 is because that was already computed. we know what epsilon 1, 1 is, and we know it's non-zero, and that leaves us only with L2, 1, and if we now just solve all of this for L2, 1, which is a unique formula for computing it, then we know what L2, 1 is, and that it is uniquely determined, and we're done with the inductive step. Now again, there are lots of little details that I've set in words. You can find those details in the actual proof. Before you look at the proof, you may actually want to try those details down for yourself to see if you really understand this. But now we have proven the inductive step. Now then you need to say one more thing, and that is at the bottom of a proof by induction, you should say, by the principle of mathematical induction, the result holds. And bingo, we've done our proof by induction, and we've proven our theorem. Now, here's the interesting thing. We've actually given an algorithm for computing the LU factorization of matrix A that is different than the algorithm that you learned in the last unit. And that particular algorithm is known as the left-looking algorithm, and it's summarized in this unit.